teaching and learning process. Today I want to illustrate law of large trials. Normally a binomial distribution, when the number of trial increases to very large, almost infinity, it tends to normal distribution, which takes a Gaussian shape. Normally the binomial distribution is given by PR of R is NCR, P to the power of R, Q to the power of N minus R, where P is the probability of occurrence of an event and Q is the probability of non-occurrence of the event. So P plus Q is equal to 1. When N becomes large, this reduces to a continuous distribution known as the normal distribution, e power minus x minus mu whole square divided by 2 sigma square, where sigma is the standard deviation, which is the square root of npq, and the mu is the mean of the distribution, which is given by n times p. So this equation reduces to this, and here is a gadget by which I allow the many marbles to pass through them. Each marble at any point meeting the nail has got equal probability of going in one direction or the other. We can take the moving in one direction as P and moving in the opposite direction as Q. At the end, the marbles are collected at various slots in this, which takes a Gaussian shape, and that is the illustration I want to give. Here is a gadget where I have arranged pins so that each in a matrix shape, in a matrix form, so that the pins are arranged alternatively with a gap in between them. And this set of pins, needles, they cascade down, and at the end there is a collecting slots at about 11 of them in this. And each direction when the marble falls down, it will be accumulated there in that place. So I am making a large number of trials. Each one marble here corresponds to one trial. You can see that there is the distribution of marbles in the various slots has got a fairly normal distribution. Actually, my number of trials is about 50 or 60 trials. If n becomes about 500 or 1000, then the exact normal distribution can be achieved. Even now, we can claim that this is a normal distribution. There is a peak value at the center, which is mu equal to 0 now, and it gradually decreases in a typical Gaussian shape, as I have already explained. Here I want to demonstrate unipolar motor. Unipolar motor consists of a battery of 1.5 volt standard battery and a screw, steel screw, and a magnet. The magnet that I am using is Allico type magnet, which is very powerful. Neodymium magnet can also be used, which is much more powerful. So these are the articles that we require: a battery, a nail or a screw, a powerful magnet, a piece of wire. So battery, the nail, and a powerful magnet. Because of magnetic field, this is suspended, and also this is also attracted by the magnet. So now I pass current. The rotation of the motor is very obvious. I released the wire, still it is rotating, because now this magnet, which is fairly heavy, acts like a flywheel and it rotates continuously. The damping is now very conspicuous, and it speed slows down, and finally it will stop. So this is called the unipolar magnet. Now, as you can see, that it rotates very fast. I release it, it continues.